What's up, guys? Welcome back to Golf Simulator Videos and Happy New Year. We're back with an exciting video. We're here with our Trackman IO. If you haven't seen those previous videos that I did on this unit, make sure you check them out because there's been a lot of discussion about what I'm going to talk about in this latest firmware release for Trackman IO. Now, this is an early release I was able to get my hands on. Trackman was nice enough to be able to give this to us to test out and show you guys ahead of the very soon to be released, you know, public version of this. This is bringing a lot to the table that people were asking for. So let's talk about it really quick. Then we'll dive in and give some examples, you know, shot examples for you guys, show you the data in action. But club speed is now added. A lot of people were saying, hey, you know, come on, we have the radar, we have the camera, we can see the club and everything. Why don't we have club path? Well, I asked that question directly, and it's because they want to make sure that their data is within that tolerance. All right, very small tolerance. That way, you know, you're getting, you know, accurate data. They were able to achieve that and they're confident with it. And so club speed is now here. Now the club speed's here, you're going to get smash factor as well. That calculation will be done and you'll get smash factor. Club path. All right, this is another one. You know, it was cool to have face angle. All right, so that's one of those things that is a precise measurement. I mean, path, if you wanted to have a more estimated number, you can kind of see the club coming in, you know, with various different, you know, cameras or radars, whatever you're using. But now that they have the club path and the face angle, they can give you that face to path number that a lot of people look for. Power that up with, you know, the impact video that I've shown you guys with this unit. I mean, obviously it's pretty robust information. So very cool that all of that is now enabled. And we're going to show you that here in just a second. Now here's a good one. This unit is out in the public now, so they're gathering as much feedback as they can from users. You're talking about various swings, various clubs, environments, everything. They were able to take that, find some unique things that they can improve upon, so they have improved ball tracking data and pick up for, you know, shots like stingers, flop shots, full swings, and chip shots. You probably noticed, I mean, all my shots, it's been working excellent. I obviously have a very clean install. I mean, it's right at specification, nice clean environment, everything along those lines. But you start getting some people with like a wild colored golf club that they haven't, you know, tested out or something like that. You know, they'll gather that and then they'll be able to improve upon. So it's cool that they were able to do that. Now, here's a good one. A warning message to the user if the PC can't keep up with the recommendations and what to do. All right, so I told everybody this is a very powerful camera inside this unit. It's utilizing the GPU, all right, on the computer. And that's really cool because it allows them for, you know, future enhancements to really unlock the camera as GPUs continue to get more powerful. But right now, if you're running in 1080p, that's native to the software anyway until they, you know, improve graphics, go to 4K, which he said they're going to do here, you know, sounds like pretty soon. I'm running a 3090. I'm still at 1080p. You know, and there's no reason not to. You have great graphics and you're going to have that instantaneous shot taking off, you know, no delays, no misses, because if you were really bogging down the GPU, it could even not be able to read the ball. So something to pay attention to. If you're going to run 4K, if you want a future proof, you could go 4090. And I think they said 4070 Ti is capable of doing 4K. And then prevention of the calibration to proceed if the Trackman IO is installed at a height outside of the normal specification. I think this is important. Someone throws it up there at, you know, 14 feet or something. They have it working, but they're getting bad data and they don't know better because they just missed, you know, in the documentation that it was a certain height. Because this is more of a DIY unit, they want to make sure you're getting the, you know, most accurate data. So they're going to let you know, hey, get a drop pull, get this thing down to that specified height. We know it's outside of the specification. So it's cool that they prevent calibration if that's the case. Background features for R&D, you know, purposes. This is really great that they're doing this. So they're actually enabling things that will allow them to gather information to have, you know, further research and development on the hardware and software. So it's cool they're doing that. And then some various bugs and improvements. But I know you guys want to see this thing in action. So let's go ahead and step over. And I think that we're going to start with just some practice. We'll go to the target practice. All right, we'll go out there to a normal shot. This is that full virtual golf, you know, practice facility that I've shown in other videos. And then what I think I'll do is take you guys out to shot analysis and show you every single data point. We'll hit a few shots doing that. So let's go ahead and just load up like a 150-yard shot. We'll take a few, show you guys. Now, first thing you want to do is go up here to upper left, all right, and let's change this. We don't need total. Let's just do carry. There's your club speed number and your smash factor. That's new stuff there. We don't need curve, but let's go ahead and do face the path, which is a new number because we didn't have club path before. And let's do, I mean, launch angle is a good number to look at, know that it's, you know, reading properly and stuff. So save and close, and we can put this thing in action. I need a golf ball, so let me grab that. So let's talk really quick about all of this data that I'm getting. Notice I have no stickers on my club. That's a unique feature to this unit. And you know, that's something a lot of people ask. They're like, well, I want club path and I want club speed and I want face angle and everything without stickers. Well, there's not a ton of units out there that can do that. I mean, honestly, I'm trying to think of you know, a higher end unit that can do that outside of this. You know, it's very impressive that they're bringing all this data to the table with no marked balls, no special golf ball needed, and then no club stickers whatsoever. So let's hit a couple shots and show you this thing in action. That's gonna be a little bit of a draw as I kinda, I lost my balance and yanked it just a little bit, but that's okay. Let's see how that data shows. You're gonna see I got a little bit of, you know, extra distance than really what I was swinging for. Spin axis, obviously, to the left, face the path was negative 5.5. So all that data really matching up, my launch angle right in that target that you'll see, you know, on all the various, you know, devices that I use and everything. So club speed, 84.7. Love that. That's right where I'm at. I'm hitting an 8-iron, just a soft 8. All right, so let's try to not lose our balance this time. I was talking there for a while. I swung a few clubs this morning, but need to get a little warmed up. A little better, still over-releasing just a little bit, so we gotta fix that. Gotta fix that. Get the club working a little bit more to the left and I feel like we're gonna be happier. Yeah, look at that face-to-path number. Now, if you went over to your data because you wanted additional data, you could look really quick at your face angle or swap it out. If you said, I don't need ball speed, you know, let's say we don't need ball speed. We could just go to face angle. And now I have that face angle number, so when I'm looking at face to path, I could add, you know, path too. Like, you don't need smash factor maybe on your 8-iron. So I could just, let's swap it out really quick. Club path, whoops, smash factor, club path. So now I'm very club centric, all right? I'm looking at those numbers that are important to me, looking at that path and looking at that face angle. So really it's a little more of my path that I need to get moving. So something to work on. Let's see if we can do it. Almost overdid it there, but you can see how I changed that entire swing by just looking at the data saying, wow, I need to get the club moving a little more left. And then shockingly enough, my club path was negative 0.7. So if you're talking about game improvement, I mean, it's that easy to just look up at your data. I recommend using a PGA professional when you're changing your swing, but if you feel confident enough to, you can look at data and you can make an adjustment, especially something like path, if you understand how to do that. I saw that ball taken off to the left and I at first thought, well, maybe I'm over-releasing. Well, I pulled up the data and it was really more of a path thing for me, and I just got that moving more to the left, and then sure enough, we were good. So let's see if we can actually hit one more like that. I like hitting little cuts. I get stuck sometimes and just can't get the club moving that direction. That was a thin one. I got it working decent, but you're going to see that launch angle be low. I mean, thin to win, right? Yeah, see, it was only 20. So my launch angle is usually, and my club path got back to that, you know, heavier negative number again. So, you know, I should say face to path did. You know, my club path was actually 1.9, but not nearly as zeroed out as I was before. So let's see if we can take one more. Too bad. It's a little bit lower on the face, but watch the spin number be good. I mean, that's, I'll take that all day. Yeah, look at the face angle. I don't mind that club path so much. And then you'll see I got that launch angle up. Spin rate was pretty good for me. I mean, a nice smooth shot there. So, I mean, we really kind of took it through its paces there to show you guys that, I mean, I got everything. Now, let's say that I needed to sweep a draw around. You know, I'll get this thing taking off to the right, you know, and drawing back, see if I can hit that shot. Probably gonna get some more distance out of it when I hit that. Yeah, a little more than I would need. But if I wanted some more distance out of my 8-iron, I could get it. I mean, look at that club path number. That was that big, you know, sweeping draw, and it picked it up, you know, just fine. Picked it up great. And you can see that extra carry distance. Spin rate was where I'd expect it. Launch angle is where I would expect it. Everything's right there. So, I mean, really checking out really, really nicely. And then what I want to do for you guys is I want to take you out to the shot analysis. And the cool, I mean, you can get that club path preview inside of Range. But if you have the fully unlocked version, there's two versions, a home version, and then obviously the higher end version, you can get this full analysis, which is very, very powerful. What I'll do is I'll even just take this up just a little bit so you guys can see all of that. You can essentially select whatever you want inside of here. So that's that club delivery video that I have selected right now. And then you could select, so you don't have to have the range on here, or you could even expand the range if you want. All right, lots, I mean, you guys have seen shot analysis before. It's very powerful stuff. So let's hit a shot and show you how you have all this data available. A little bit of a draw there. Notice how I've got ball speed, spin rate, carry, launch angle, spin axis, launch direction, face angle, face to path, impact offset, dynamic loft, club path, club speed, impact height, curve, height, total, side, landing angle, smash factor, everything. Now, the only thing I noticed is that I see like club path and club speed in italics. Now, I wonder if that means anything or not. We're going to have to ask Trackman that. I mean, obviously it picked everything up quite well. Notice how I got inside on that again. I mean, that's my miss almost. See if we can fix it a little bit. That was not well executed at all. Look at the strike and the face and everything. You know, that must be just the way, because it was showing it normal in the other ones. But I also have to ask him that, because that does look like it has a italics there. I don't think that's a big deal. Because it is showing the face to path number in a normal state. So that might be something that they're adjusting before the full release. Keep in mind, this is a beta version that I'm using. So we'll share that feedback with them. It's gonna go to the right. I like showing all these shot shapes though. All right, so we were able to get the club path 0.6 that time. I mean, it's awesome seeing all the data in action. I mean, this is a lot. Let's pull this up really quick. If I click on one of these numbers down here, actually, I think I have, let's go ahead. Let's pull up. There we go. Now it's nice and large for you guys. So this is every single data point available in a nice large format for you guys, so you could see it. If you wanted something else on the right, like club delivery, you could have that. And you could, you know, be looking at your data, and I actually like clicking and dragging with the mouse, but you could see the club delivery come in and say, all right, I kind of fixed that. That wasn't really coming, you know, from the inside as much that time. I'm getting closer. Look at your actual, you know, you can look at face angle, you know, clear as day on this thing. You can look at the ball spinning, everything. So shot analysis for, you know, someone that's teaching, you know, someone that's really working on something. I mean, look at impact. That's just such a great way to show impact. And I apologize that I'm kind of covering up some of the numbers there with my video. I can, you know, shrink it down just for a second so you guys could see that. Not really missing much. I mean, impact height, curve, landing angle. But this image of impact, I think, is just so well executed. I mean, you can see the center dot. You can see the center of the club face. And then if you're trying to verify it, you can literally just go to your club delivery and, you know, drag your image right to the impact. I mean, it's spot on. It's very, very cool. So, like I said, guys, this is just a first look video. Back at it. I was actually gone on vacation with the family for a few days. Tested this for a little bit before I left. Now it's the first of the year. And talked to Trackman. They said, hey, you can go ahead and show the beta. Very, very cool stuff. I'm excited to see what all keeps coming with this unit. Like I said, their ability to have that camera kind of unlocked with GPU processing, I think is going to be very, very powerful, let alone the software that can continue to be developed. So I'd love to hear what you guys think. Make sure you comment below, questions you have, you know, thoughts, feedback, anything along those lines. I'd love to hear it. And make sure you stay tuned. There's a lot more coming. We'll be down at the 2024 PGA merchandise show here real shortly, and I'm sure there's going to be all kinds of great things to show you guys. So make sure you stay tuned for that. We'll have a lot more coming soon.